In this video, I want to introduce some ideas about what we call neurodevelopmental disorders. Neurodevelopmental disorders. So disorders of any type of pathology may affect the nervous system at any point during its development. And when pathology affects the nervous system early in its development, the syndrome that results may not appear until months or years later, at a time when the child would normally start using the functions of the affected area. A common example is walking. There may be injury to the brain or the spinal cord that includes motor areas involved in moving the legs for walking. But since most children don't start walking until they're about a year old or so, even if that injury happens when the nervous system is developing prior to birth, we won't see that problem walking until the child first should start walking about a normal age, when they would normally start using those areas for walking, and then it doesn't happen. When that happens, when a child is having significantly late performance of milestones, neurodevelopmental milestones in one or more functional groups, we call that neurodevelopmental delay. And significant delays are usually from a neurodevelopmental disorder. Sometimes, however, a child will be delayed in one or more milestones a little bit, and then they'll catch up with their peers. So a little bit of delay at certain points during neurodevelopment can be normal for some children. Some common examples of neurodevelopmental disorders, or really kind of categories or groups of neurodevelopmental disorders, include what are called neural tube defects. Neural tube defects. What is called cerebral palsy, cerebral or cerebral palsy, and what is called intellectual disability. Neural tube defects involve syndromes that occur with abnormal closure of the neural tube. So when that part of the ectoderm is rolling up into the neural tube, if something interferes with that process, then there's a defect in the formation of the neural tube. We call that neural tube defects. There are several other names for particular syndromes under this category of neural tube defects. What we most commonly see when the neural tube doesn't close properly is an abnormality of the spinal cord. And there are a few different versions of this. And sometimes we can see abnormalities of the brain as well. Cerebral palsy refers to a number of syndromes that involve abnormal motor functions from brain injury that occurs early during development. And there are several different areas in the brain that may be affected to cause the motor abnormalities that result. Intellectual disability, which has had a number of different names over time, refers to abnormalities of cognition, the cognitive functions. And this involves abnormal development of the cerebral cortex, specifically the outermost layer of the cerebrum. And this may occur from many causes, such as the genetic disorder called Down syndrome, which is one of the most common causes. So these neurodevelopmental disorders, or these collections of syndromes that fall under the category of neurodevelopmental disorders, and many other neurodevelopmental disorders, may occur in isolation. A person may just have neural tube defects, or just cerebral palsy, or just intellectual disability, or, quite commonly, a patient may have an overlapping syndrome with features of several disorders happening at the same time.